In a time where your online profile defines who, how, and where you date, we strip away the likes and the swipes, leaving only the unfiltered truth.
As we have a more instinctive way to find love. Can picking a partner based solely on natural beauty...
Oh.
Wowzers.
Okay.
...help you find the one?
Wow.
This is the first time I have seen a vagina.
Yeehaw!
We like to start where a good date ends.
Time to see some poo-poo.
Naked. Tonight, a taxi driver, a beautician and a personal trainer let it all hang out for their potential soulmates.
Come on, fancy them. They look like they got babies in there.
What is that?
Lick the lizard.
Well, I'm looking for the dick that I want to suck for the first time.
Would that hurt me, though?
I had 17 piercings.
You
have... I've only got 6 now.
Drama!
I've never had a tit wank before.
We know it's what's on the inside that counts.
He can make his cock move.
Oh, my God.
But you've got to like what's on the outside first.
Woo! You're what I call sex or legs.
Yeah, banger, isn't it?
So you're the queen of the blowjob?
Blimey.
It's time to try dating in reverse. This is Naked Attraction.
Welcome to Naked Attraction, the show where no one gets their undies in a twist because we have a thread count lower than a Victoria's Secret show. Inside each of these 6 pods, I've lined up a naked singleton. Only one of them will be picked to go on a date, but who's doing the choosing?
I'm Nicola and I'm Northampton's number one MILF in the age 45 to 50 category. I completely embrace being a MILF. I have been called Mrs. McKenzie of the Inbetweeners. Yeah, I would say I'm a bit of a party animal. I went to Ibiza with my mate and we did like back-to-back pool parties. Unbelievably, I got chatted up by a 25-year-old Italian fitness model, but being old enough to be his mummy, I didn't go there. I'm really not sure why I'm single. Maybe you better ask my ex-husbands that one.
And I'm coming on telly to tell everyone what a failure I am.
I found out I'd gone through premature menopause by 41. It has changed my outlook on life, but in a positive way. I want to show that postmenopausal women can be sexy, sassy and classy. Naked Attraction, please help me find husband number 3.
So, Nikki, welcome. Now, as Northampton's number one MILF in the 45 to 50 category, how come you're single?
Oh, and I have to say that is a self-awarded title. If you say it enough, you'll believe it, but...
I am single, but I have been married 2 times.
OK. So you're looking for hubby number 3?
Oh, absolutely. That's why I'm on Naked Attraction.
Can I just say, I am desperate for a Naked Attraction wedding. So what are you looking for?
I'm obviously looking for a man with a big personality, but maybe some of the big things as well.
Oh, so you like a big willy?
Yes, I know how to say I love big dick in several different languages.
What is it in French?
It's j'adore le grand coq, or ich liebe großen Schwanz in German.
So you're ready to play the game?
I cannot wait.
So in front of you, you have got 6 coloured pods. Inside each of them is a gorgeous naked man. They each have an attribute that you have told us you find physically attractive. All you've got to do is whittle those fellas down from 6 to 1, just using Naked Attraction alone. Come
on, let's do it, Anna.
So if you could reveal the bottom half of the bodies.
Oh, my goodness. Wowzers.
There's quite a sausage selection.
There is. There's quite a few bratwurst. Green. Definitely tickling my fancy.
I'm sure he is, even from there.
Oh, my goodness, that would make your eyes water, wouldn't
That's
it?
That's going to take your eye out. I mean, what's the biggest that you've had?
A good, solid 9 inches and girthy. I don't tend to do anything smaller than an iPhone. Otherwise, it's a friend zone situation.
So green you could absolutely handle?
Yes, yeah.
Good.
I'm feeling this gentleman here with a lovely tattoo.
Orange.
Now, he's got lovely, sturdy thighs.
What about his willy?
I think it's very aesthetically pleasing.
OK, where next?
I think yellow.
A very tanned ball sack.
But I might need to know the shower or a grower from this lovely gentleman.
Are you a grower? Definitely a grower.
And nice, sturdy thighs, so yeah.
So, you know, what kind of a lover are you? Are you a good lover?
Well, I used to think so, but my ex said I had all the sexual allure of a McDonald's drive-thru. You just leave strangely unsatisfied.
What a charmer.
I know.
Thank you, darling.
Exactly.
OK, any other burgers you want to have a look at here?
Well, I'm liking this Big Mac in front of me here in red.
With red?
He has a very good-looking penis, so he's certainly ticking my box on that one.
I'm loving the scab on the knee.
It's not carpet burn.
Is it carpet burn? Oh, we've got a player. OK, moving on. Pink, not a pube in sight.
I know, he's very well manscaped. It's a good size, isn't it?
It is a good size.
Gorgeous.
Oh, we've not looked at blue.
No, we haven't.
Hello, blue. Ooh. He's looked after himself. He's obviously trimmed his pews, but
nicely
a bit more
escaped.
Hair.
Yeah, that's fine. That's all good.
So, Nikki, I mean, you've seen the first half of the bodies and there's a lot to take
there
in.
There is a lot.
But one of them has to go.
It might have to be red.
Why red?
I think it's because I don't want to cause carpet burn number two.
Fair enough. So, Nikki, you are saying farewell, adieu to Andy. He is 41 and he's a project manager from Portsmouth. Come on down. Oh, look, and he's gorgeous as well.
He is absolutely
and he's
gorgeous.
Got the tattoos.
I'm gutted.
Carpet burn. Is that like a sex injury?
Yes.
You and your carpet burns, slide on out.
Oh, Nikki.
She was a stereotypical MILF. I'm gutted that I didn't get the chance to go on a date with her.
OK, five lovely men remaining. Here we go.
Let's go for it.
Can we reveal the middle part of the bodies, please?
I really fancy going to check out orange.
So that's pretty incredible, the tattoo across the shoulder and the arm.
Amazing. And a pierced nipple. Juicy, isn't it? I don't know whether he could just give me a little spin so I could see the ones on the side and the back.
That's a devil's tail.
That is, isn't it? Cheeky.
If he's the devil, are you a saint?
No.
Exactly. That's what I was just about to say. No chance. Where else?
Let's have a look at pink. He is, like, super, super toned. That V bit is so sexy.
Ooh. Look at that. Does that look like a sort of 45 to 50-year-old bod?
I'm thinking a bit younger. I have had a couple of encounters with younger men. Well, it's very nice. I mean, they had, like, abs you could grate cheese on, but as
nice.
I'm looking for husband number three...
True.
I think perhaps someone more my own age.
Oh, ooh. Pink's in the right age bracket,
Absolutely.
Then. Absolutely. So... As a single girl, do you get to sort of go on a holiday with your girlfriends a lot and just sort of go and party?
Well, I had the most ace holiday last year with my best friend in Ibiza. Hot pants, glow sticks out.
Nicola isn't alone in hitting Ibiza later in life. One travel company reported a 38% rise in older travellers heading to the island. But be careful before getting amorous. as it's not just super clubs that Ibiza's home to. It's also where the first UK cases of super gonorrhea, a drug-resistant strain of the STI, came from.
My dream man would be someone that you can party with and have fun and then just Netflix and chill with.
Are you listening, boys? Nikki likes to rave. So imagine that this is Ibiza. Grab your glow sticks, bust out those moves.
Y'all ready for this?
Here we go. Whoop, whoop, woo. It's coming your way. Come on, boys. Come on, Blue. Blue's got the moves.
Blue's got the moves.
The running man orange.
And green as well.
Incredible.
Yellow's doing well.
Love that pink.
Loving it.
Well, who had the moves that drew your eye?
It's got to be Blue. He was just swinging that glow stick. I'm also really liking the chest hair. I think it's very manly.
Yellow. He was busting out a few moves.
I think so, yeah. Looks great and it looks strong. I love a guy who can, like, pick me up.
Liking this, Nikki. OK. It's decision time.
They are all good, aren't they? I think yellow.
Yellow? Why?
Because I always wear heels. He looks like he might be a titch.
A little bit too small.
Yes.
So, Nikki, you are saying goodbye to the lovely David. He is 42. He's a taxi driver from Whitley Bay. Come on down. Hello, David. Are you a bit disappointed?
A little bit. I thought I'd get a bit further than this.
Unfortunately, it ain't gonna be a day. Take yourself and that very tight ball sack through those arches.
I think Nikki goes for, like, a bit more well-endowed men, but it was a bit cold in there, that's why.
Coming up, Nicola bears all before choosing who to date.
It's so tough.
And a brand new singleton gets to pick a partner based on naked attraction.
A tricky decision.
Earlier, digital designer Nicola whittled six men down to four based on naked attraction alone. She can only choose one man to go on that date, so who will she lose next?
Oh, my goodness. Wowzers.
Now, before we carry on, just remind us, why are you here?
Well, you know, it's Northampton's number one MILF. I'm living life to the full and looking for husband number three on
exactly.
Naked Attraction.
So, we've got four boys remaining. Can we reveal the boys' faces, please?
I'm feeling Ibiza raver, Blue. He's got a very handsome face and I really like the hair. Is it all right to have a spin? Just to have a look at those flowing locks? Wow.
Shake it. You're definitely not 45, are you, Blue?
No, I think I'd have to get my cougar on there, wouldn't I?
It was the Canadians who first coined the term cougar to mean an older woman seeking a younger man. And a recent study found 40% of young men would prefer to date a cougar, as she's more likely to be experienced and body confident. Demi Moore was once crowned most coveted cougar of all time by a dating website. But if, like Madonna and Joan Collins, you're a woman over 60, you reach the higher echelons of being a saber-tooth.
Who else do you want to go to?
I'm feeling pink.
You're feeling pink?
Feeling pink.
Pink has certainly been giving you the eye, Nikki.
He has got the most gorgeous smile. Now I have teeth like Austin Powers crossed with Nanny McPhee, so anyone who's got a beautiful smile is like...
He's a plus.
Is absolutely.
Shall we go to green?
I love a beard. I find it very masculine.
Gee.
Yes.
So you could see yourself rolling around on a mattress with this one?
Yes.
Well, look, let's talk about your sex drive, because you're in your mid-40s now, and as we all know, ladies go through the change?
I actually went through sort of premature menopause.
Oh, did you?
Which was in my late 30s.
That's so early.
So on the plus side, no one's going to get me pregnant. And
bingo.
I'm kind of HRT'd up to the max.
Oh, are you?
Raring to go, Anna.
Are you nice and juicy and moist?
Yeah, no saggy buggy fannies here. Bring on the dicks.
I couldn't have said it better myself. Let's go and have a look at orange. Now, that's quite a piercing going on.
Very sexy.
This is not a boy that's in his 40s or 50s. 30s?
Oh, no.
Lower!
No!
So, Nikki, decision time. You've got to lose one of these fellas. Who's it going to be?
This is really tough. I think it's going to have to be orange, unfortunately.
So you're losing orange?
I know.
Because?
Maybe just a smidge too young.
So, Nikki, you are saying farewell to Daniel. He is 27. He's a ceiling fixer from Newcastle, the Toon. Come down, Daniel.
What am I doing? I could have had a toy boy.
Have you had a MILF before, Daniel?
No, would have been my first.
Are you a little bit disappointed?
Quite a lot, but...
Daniel, I'm so sorry. It is not going to be a date for you.
Farewell.
Oh, he looks like a naughty little devil, doesn't he?
Nikki, unfortunately, it's not a date. You've missed out on me massive sausage roll.
Now, in this round, you get to hear the boys speak. So, we heard earlier on that Nicola's performance in the bedroom was akin to a takeaway. If you were to describe your lovemaking as a fast food takeaway, what would it be and why?
I think let's try pink. He looks a tasty takeaway treat.
Fried chicken, because it's finger-licking good.
Ooh.
Do you like finger-licking good sex?
What lady doesn't, eh?
And what did you think of his voice?
Yeah, very cheeky.
Who else do you want to go to?
Green.
I'm going to say a vindaloo. It was hot and spicy.
Ooh.
What do you think of the voice?
Nice.
That leaves blue. What's your lovemaking like?
A chicken tikka, because everybody loves it.
Do you like the sound of blue's voice?
I do. It's a very nice voice. I really thought one of them would say Burger King.
Why?
Because they've got whoppers.
OK, so you've seen the boys, you've heard the boys. You're going to have to lose one of the boys.
Blue, chicken tikka.
Blue?
I think he's absolutely gorgeous, but I just think there's going to be a lot of hair going on, isn't there?
Oh, I see. Yeah. OK. So, Nikki, you are going to kick yourself because you're saying goodbye to Ian. He's a 32-year-old wrestler.
No.
From Manchester. Oh, Ian, come down and say hello.
Oh, I'm so sorry. No.
Could you wrestle a MILF?
Oh, yeah. Pick you up, put you down.
A body slam.
Oh, my goodness.
Take yourself through the arch.
Nikki, you're missing out. He could have been getting a powerbomb tonight or an Arabian face buster, but you made your choice.
You've seen them in all their glory.
Yes.
Now it's their turn, OK? Because next time you come back out here, it's with your kit off.
Oh my goodness, I'll be kind.
Get yourself through there.
Based on Naked Attraction, Nicola has whittled six guys down to two. 45-year-old handyman Ian and 53-year-old telecoms engineer Joe. But she can only choose one guy to go on that date to find out if there's chemistry when the clothes go on.
So, Ian, Joe, you are the final two. Happy to be here?
Very happy.
Do you both fancy Nikki?
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah? Do you want to see the goods?
Oh, yeah.
OK, come on out in all of your glory. Well, hello, madam. Hi, look at you. Incredible bosoms. You look amazing, Nikki.
Thank you.
So, Ian, take a look at Nikki. What are you liking?
Everything. I can see why she was voted Miss Mill 45 to 50.
I do.
You really can.
Totally. Joe, how are you feeling?
I love her smile. I love her boobs. And I love her vagina.
Thank you.
OK, you've got two amazing fellas here. You are now picking the boy you want to go on a date with. You've got Ian and you've got Joe.
I think it's going to have to be Joe.
You're going with Joe! That's a congratulations!
I mean, it may have been the battle of the schlongs, but I think it was the cheeky smile that got it for me.
So, Ian, that close. But listen, you take your massive schlong out of here.
Thank you. Nicky, you might not have picked me tonight, but you give this 45-year-old man the whole world of confidence. Yeah, I'm back.
So, congratulations, congratulations, Joe. Are you pleased?
I'm over the moon.
Oh, that's lovely.
Looking forward to the date.
Me too, I cannot wait.
Talking of dates, next time you see each other, it's going to be with your clothes back on. Have the best of nights. See you guys later. Bye.
She's got a lovely smile, she's pretty, she's got a very super sexy body. Yeah, she's just a beautiful lady.
I came here today looking for a gorgeous man with a big personality, a great smile and a big appendage, and Joe certainly ticked all of those boxes for me.
Our couple wanted to have a proper romantic date, so we made sure they tested negative for COVID first.
Hey, good to see you. How are you?
I'm good. Good, isn't it? Yeah.
He's a really nice dresser, so seeing him with his clothes on, I definitely wasn't disappointed.
I have to say, thank you for picking me.
It was your smile. You have got such a lovely face and a gorgeous...
And you're so sexy. I thought she looked stunning, really beautiful. I seem to have a mutual connection. Let's feel your hands. Oh, your hands are cold.
Maybe you'll have to warm me up a bit. Yes, as a postmenopausal woman, it is so nice to have someone who thinks I'm hot and sexy.
I'm looking for husband number three.
Wow. Well, they do say third time lucky.
Well, if it ends up being me, I hope it'll be your last time.
Oh, it's lush.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, he seems quite keen for a long-term relationship, which I'm really pleased about. You know, my first proposal was in 6 weeks of meeting, so who knows, could be a record. It's been really great getting to know Joe. He seems like a super sweet guy.
I think we'll definitely see each other again. She could well be the one.
I'd certainly like to try that takeout finger-licking chicken. Hi.
You OK?
Yeah, I'm good.
How did the date go?
I had a great time on the date. I mean, we had a lot of fun,
yeah,
didn't
we? Yeah, we had a great time.
It's been a long time since I've kissed such a lovely man.
It was better kissing afterwards. And we had spent a night together.
We also had dinner and drinks as well. Yeah.
What happened after the date?
After the first couple of weeks, I think Nicola had a change of mind. It seemed to be like a complete turnaround, and I didn't really understand why.
As much as I wanted to feel those feels about Joe, something wasn't quite gelling for me, and that's not a reflection on Joe.
How does that make you feel, Joe?
Well, it doesn't make me feel any better, because obviously we've come to an end, but I guess I'll have to live with it.
It was such a great experience, wasn't it?
I want it again.
Welcome back to Naked Attraction, the show that's got more pussies and puppies on display than a pet shop. Now, inside each of these six pods, I've lined up a naked singleton. Only one of them will be picked to go on a date. But who's choosing this time?
I'm Mark, I'm 35, and I'm from Derbyshire. 10 years ago, I had a wife, an apartment, career. Then it all came crashing down. My marriage ended and I needed to get away, so I spent 18 months travelling around the world. Going travelling was a way to push myself. I went to Thailand and I did training Muay Thai kickboxing. I think it did actually help a lot with my confidence. When I was 17, I got Crohn's disease. I had to have surgery and have a colostomy bag fitted. Getting naked scares the hell out of me. Particularly on a first date, if things are going well, it can be a bit of a mood killer getting naked for the first time. Now I'm looking to find a woman who's as adventurous as me, who'll love how I look so I can conquer my fear.
So, Mark, welcome to Naked Attraction. Got to ask you, why are you single?
I think moving around quite a lot whilst travelling means that it's difficult to get to know anyone that well.
OK, so, Mark, we know that you have Crohn's disease. What exactly is it?
My own white blood cells were attacking my insides. 10 years ago, I had surgery to remove the disease, and I was left with this colostomy bag on my tummy. I was finding it difficult to get naked with new people.
Okay.
So I thought I would smash that fear and come and get naked on national TV.
Smash that fear? We will. OK, in front of you, you have got 6 coloured pods, each of which contains a gorgeous young woman, completely naked, and they each have an attribute that you have said you find physically attractive. We're going to reveal them to you bit by bit. All you have to do is whittle them down from 6 to 1, using Naked Attraction alone.
It's a tough job.
Let's reveal the bottom half of the bodies.
Wow.
Nervous giggles?
Yeah. That's a lot of poo-poos.
Take it all in, Mark, take it all in.
Let's get stuck in.
Come on, then.
Let's go say hello to Blue.
What has caught your eye about Blue?
The leg tattoo. It was beckoning me.
Nothing else. What is it that you like about that?
There's a little piercing there as well, right?
Okay, exactly. So you spotted that from 20 yards.
I've never seen one. It would be different, right?
Imagine it must be amazing for the girl.
Yeah. Let's go to orange.
OK.
Very neat vagina. Could be painted on.
I love that. So you've got like a sort of vaginal transfer.
Yeah.
OK, so what do you like to do with a muff?
I like to do a few different things, you know.
Really?
To start with a little long, slow surprise.
What's a long, slow surprise?
You know, you like start at the bottom with like a long, slow lick.
So up the labia.
Yeah, that's like the initial surprise.
Yeah, that's a double thumbs up.
Double thumbs up. Let's go to the other side.
OK, over to green.
Also tattoo.
It's a sort of flying horse. Are you a bit of a rider, Green? Yes! How do you feel about her vulva?
Very neat and tidy. Nice to get stuck into.
Yep, boom, tick. Where else should we go?
To pink.
This lady has got some pubic hair.
Yeah.
And it looks as though that pubic hair is a bit sculpted pink.
Is it an arrow? Yeah, it's an arrow.
Oh, it's an arrow!
In case you get lost on the way down. That implies she wants
one of your special presents.
Indeed, yeah. Let's go to yellow.
Now, can I just see what that tattoo is? Lick the lizard! Would you go and lick that lizard, Mark?
I would.
OK, well, there you go. It works,
right,
yellow. It works.
Let's go to red. Also very taken care of.
Yes.
Bit more lips on show.
Yep.
Something to get stuck into.
All right, it's decision time. Here are your 6 gorgeous ladies. You have to lose one of them. Which one are you going to go for?
It's a tricky decision. I'm going to have to say green.
Why green, please?
I'm not sure about the tattoo, and maybe a bit less of a confident swag in the box.
So, Mark, you are about to say goodbye to Roxy. She's 40. She's a personal trainer from Poole. Come down, say hi.
Hi.
Hi, gorgeous. What a bod.
Yeah.
She is a very fit woman. Unfortunately, it's not going to be
not
a
for
date.
Me today.
Back to the gym for you, love.
All right, thanks very
bye
much.
Bye-bye.
He's an attractive guy. It would have been nice to have a little wrestle and work out and get sweaty together, really.
So you've still got five girls remaining. Can we please see the middle part of the bodies?
It's the breasts. Let's start at pink.
Okay, so you're going straight for the smaller boobs.
I am. They're really good nipples. They are nice and pointy.
The thing is, as a lady that has been well-blessed in that department, I can give an unbelievable tit-wank. So I'm just thinking...
You don't always need the big boobs to enjoy it. You can still sort of press it all in together. Let's go to yellow. There's a shiny thing that catches my eye. Never been with anyone with a nipple piercing.
So you like these boobs?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
So look, talk to me a little bit more about your sex life. How's it changed since you've had your surgery?
There are some things that may be a bit more tricky. If you pick someone up.
Yeah.
Like grabbing around the waist, that might be a bit tricky.
You've got to be mindful.
Yeah.
Of the fact that there's a sort of a medical bag there.
Yeah.
Mark is one of up to 6,000 people diagnosed with Crohn's disease every year in the UK. This incurable condition inflames the wall of the digestive tract, often causing severe pain in the affected area as well as diarrhea. While medication can ease the flare-ups, in some cases surgery is needed to remove the affected part of the gut to be replaced with a colostomy bag that collects the faeces.
Where next?
Orange.
Mm-hmm.
Curvy. There's that perfect sort of...
Oh, the hourglass.
Curve. Yeah, the hourglass is...
It's key.
Exciting, yeah.
Let's have a look at red.
Say hello to red. Nice and curvy, keeps in shape.
Are those boobs kind of, like, manageable for you?
Yeah, I think so.
Because you are fit yourself, you are keen to find a girl that you can sort of share some of your interests with.
It's difficult to find a sparring partner.
So, ladies, here is your chance to impress him with your best martial art move. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Keep going. Oh, yellow's got it.
The power. I appreciate the effort the red's putting in.
Come on, Blue. There you go. Thank you very much indeed, ladies. Mark, you look shell-shocked.
Yeah, that was mind-blowing.
So, it's time to lose one of the girls.
I'm afraid... It's going to be... Orange.
Orange? Why?
Felt like she wasn't quite getting so much into the kicking.
So, Mark, you are going to say goodbye to Sian. She's a beautician. She's 28 and she is from Spalding. Come and join us, Sian. Wow, she looks amazing.
She does.
How are you feeling, Sian?
A bit gutted, but yeah.
I'm so sorry. It's not going to be a date, but thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Sian. See you later. Great looking girl.
Yeah.
I really don't have a type. As long as they're taller than me, that's it.
And I don't think he was.
Coming up, Mark bears all before choosing who to date.
I'm going to take...
Earlier, Globetrotter Mark whittled six potential dates down to four based solely on naked attraction. He can only choose one to take on a date, so who will he lose next?
Things start getting tricky.
So, Mark, just remind us, why are you here?
When I was 17, I got Crohn's disease.
I didn't want the colostomy bag to hold me back. I was finding it difficult to get naked with new people. I thought,
What's scarier than naked attraction?
That's
indeed.
It.
All right. Can we please see the girls' faces? Gorgeous girls.
Yeah, Mark. They are. Let's go and look at Pink. Pink's very pretty, long hair, mm-hmm. and dark, mysterious eyes. And long hair is very feminine. Should we go to Blue? Blonde hair, light eyes, very nice.
The lip piercing as well.
Oh, yeah, little one that's glinting in the studio lights.
Mm. So, Mark, are you romantic?
The most romantic thing I've ever done is propose. I went back to the place that we met, got down on one knee.
Oh, wow.
All the classic textbook romance.
Men are actually more romantic than we think. In a recent study, nearly half claimed to have fallen in love at first sight, while only 28% of women made the same claim. But while men aren't shy when it comes to dishing out the champagne and chocolates, they're also more likely to cheat, with a third saying they'd indulged in extramarital relations. Makes you wonder if all that romance is making up for a guilty conscience.
Where do you want to go next?
Red. Very pretty also, and...
Very natural-looking girl, I think.
Yeah, for sure, yeah. You can have too much makeup, so...
So less is more, maybe, for you.
Yeah, unless you go all out for a big night out. I think yellow would be up for a big night out.
Yellow's totally up for a big night out. What do you reckon?
I can tell these are much lighter eyes and a tongue piercing. Wow, that was
quite a... That's a come
a
on.
A move there, yeah.
All right, it's decision time.
Things start getting tricky. I think I'm going to have to choose... Yellow.
Why yellow?
I'm a bit of a shy guy. I think yellow might be a lot to handle.
Well, Mark, you are saying goodbye to Helen. She's 36, she's a catering assistant, and she's from Sheffield. Hello. Well, you look absolutely incredible. And you clearly, you're a bit of a party girl.
Yeah, single life is just going out at the moment, but obviously I've not met the right one today, so...
Thank you very much indeed, Helen.
Thank you.
Take your lizard out of here.
At the end of the day, I'm sure there's a man out there what would happily lick my lizard.
Now, this is the voice round.
Yeah.
Do you like an accent? Have you got a specific voice that you like?
Yeah, there's a lot of very sexy accents. Scottish, it's very good.
What was that?
Scottish.
You've literally just offended
an entire nation. Yeah.
So, girls, Mark, as you know, is a very, very keen traveller. So which travel destination best describes you and why? Who do you want to go for first?
Blue.
OK, I'm into space because I'm a bit of a pocket rocket.
I wasn't expecting that voice.
If you have a rocket, let's jump in.
Wow, OK.
Red.
Well, it'll have to be Bangkok because it's really busy and I like the rush.
Northern.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Yeah, I like the answer.
Good, strong, confident voice.
Mm-hmm, very good. Pink.
I would say I'm from Iceland because I'm always cold, but you can warm me up.
Chilly.
Chilly and mysterious.
It was quite a posh accent.
Do you like a little bit of posh?
I do. I'm like a secret posh person. I like gravy with my sushi.
OK, I love that. This is a tough decision. You have to lose one of them.
Hmm. I am... going to choose red, I'm afraid.
OK, why?
It was a lovely voice, but I've been up north.
The very fact that you're northern and Mark has been up north, it's over for you. So you are saying goodbye to the lovely Robin. She's 37. She's a project support officer from Scotland.
Hi.
How does it feel to know that you've been rejected simply because Mark's been up north?
I have a mix of accents, confuses everyone.
It's back up the M62 for you. Farewell.
Mark throws me off because I'm northern, but there's a lot to me. I'm like an onion, peel the layers off.
OK, you are left with two beautiful girls.
Yeah.
The next time they see you, it's with your kit off.
I'm ready.
See you later.
Based on Naked Attraction, Globetrotter Mark has whittled six potential dates down to two. 35-year-old chef Emma and 36-year-old supervisor Kirsty. But only one can go on a date to find out if there's chemistry when the clothes go on.
So Emma, Kirsty, hello, congratulations. You're down to the final two. Up until this point, you've seen Mark with his kit on. All of that is about to change. Yes. Out you come, Mark. Let's see what you've got. You look amazing.
Thank you. Yeah,
now,
I've been working out.
Can I introduce you to your two ladies? You've got Emma, you've got Kirsty.
Hi.
Let's get it out of the way. There's your bag.
This is it.
Kirsty.
Yeah, it's invisible to me. I've dated someone with one before, so it makes no odds.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Emma?
Doesn't bother me at all. It's absolutely fine.
What about the rest of your body, Kirsty?
Yeah, I think you're gorgeous, man.
Amazing body.
Yeah, do we get a twirl, though?
Got a twirl?
Yeah, definitely.
And Emma, how do you feel about Mark's body?
Yeah, it's not much to not like, really, is it? I mean, like, very good looking, nice body, good package.
OK, well, listen, Mark, two gorgeous girls.
Yep.
You have Emma. You have Kirsty. Only one of them you can take on a date.
I am going to take Emma.
Emma!
I thought, Emma, I liked your accent. I thought you sounded very lovely, which is what I'm looking for.
Oh, Kirsty!
Sorry, I love Emma, so I'm happy for you, yeah?
See you later, Kirsty.
Bye. He's a lovely bloke.
I'm hoping if the date goes well, we can take things further.
High anticipation, it's an emotional trap.
Hiya.
Hi there. How's it going?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks. A bit nervous.
Me too. When Em walked in, she looked really lovely. She's very pretty, yeah. Got the impression that you liked me.
Yeah, definitely. The thing came up and I was like, oh my God, you're actually good looking. And then you came back naked and I was just like blown away.
I do fancy him. He would be what I would choose. He's quite charming. So we'll just see how that plays out.
You're very beautiful.
Thank you.
Emma seems really lovely. A bit shy, but she's starting to open up.
What do you do?
I'm currently a chef.
What's your, like, signature dish?
Bolognese.
Italian. I like to be catered for. So it was very appealing that she's a chef. It'd be very interesting to taste her bolognese. No innuendo intended.
How long have you been travelling for?
I was doing it for about 18 months to start with.
Uh-huh.
The whole thing was, like, a chance to have more me time.
Yeah.
Because I was in a relationship for a long time.
Oh, OK. If someone's been in a long-term relationship, that's better for me because I know they can be committed to someone.
If I could find someone to go to Iceland with, I would go there.
Is that what you're waiting for? The camp buddies?
Yeah. Mark could be boyfriend material. I've never really seen someone that's good looking, they've got a nice body, and well, they've got everything that I like, sort of thing, in one person.
Cheers to travel buddy.
Cheers to that.
We've had a good laugh, and I think me and Emma will swap numbers and stay in touch. Hello, how's it going?
Yeah, good, thanks.
How did the date go for you guys?
I felt like you didn't give me much.
I wasn't giving much away, see, I'm like that, though.
So maybe I go a bit too, like, polite and it wasn't so flirty.
Yeah. I sort of bounce off the other person, I think, really. I think as I was getting the nice, polite vibe, I was probably, that's what I was bouncing back.
I wasn't bouncy enough.
So after the date, was there any communication?
Yeah, you messaged me, you'd be like, oh, I think we should just be friends.
Mm. Well, yeah, basically, because Mark wants to carry on travelling. That's not in my plan future for many years. So there's no point dating.
Still fun. Like, yeah. Get to know someone, get a bit tipsy and...
Exactly, get your leg over.
Maybe.
I'm not really looking for that sort of thing.
Would you like to test the power of naked attraction? If you're single and looking for love, go to channel4.com/take part.